I taught maybe 3 days a week, or maybe 2 days a week with a day of office hours. And the rest of the time I stayed home and worked. And I worked on poems first thing in the day for almost my entire life. The first part of the day has been the day for time of the day for poems. And I was worried about my students, but I managed to make an island 6 a.m. to 8 a.m. in the morning, when I wouldn't think about papers to be corrected or students with emotional problems or students falling behind in their work. And I could just write poems. So I would get up with black coffee and write for 2 hours. And then, bing, I would start thinking about the classes I was teaching and the work I had to do and so on. I was writing little prose at the time and mostly poetry. My son was 3, 4 years old, and when he heard me get up in the morning, of course he wanted to play. So he would come downstairs in his blue Dr. Denton's and his red hair and want to play with Daddy. And I figured out something to do. I told him, well, I'm writing poems, you know. And I said, well, I'll write you a poem. What do you want me to write about? And he was probably hungry, so he'd say something like toast, and I would write the poem. It feels so good to be extremely buttery, what the toast said. And then he wanted me to draw a picture of toast. Well, my drawing is notorious, like my singing. And but I would, he didn't mind, he was 4 years old. And I'd go back up to his room clutching his poem and be satisfied so I could get back to work. I did I always wanted to make my living writing. At that point, when I was beginning teaching, I thought I never would. But there was something in me that wanted it, to write other things as well. And one day, Andrew came to me when he was 4 and said that he had a wonderful idea, but it was scary. He was going to go to the lion store and buy a lion seed and grow a lion in a pot in the windowsill. And I said, thank you. And I wrote a children's book called Andrew the Lion Farmer, of a little boy doing just that, you know, so on. He was so proud. He was incredibly proud of that thing. And I did write occasional literary articles. And I began to write for the New York Times Book Review, lots of little casual pieces, some book reviews, and so on. Every now and then I tried a story, but it was almost entirely poetry. And my poetry began to change at that time for a number of reasons. Maybe I had been looking for change. I had been becoming dissatisfied with the kind of poetry that I was writing even before, I mean, in my last year as a junior fellow. I wrote a poem called Je Suis une table, taking it as a language mistake, like Je Suis la plume de ma tante or something. And In it, I inhabit a thickening. I am a table. And it means I can't speak what's on my mind. But I wrote it in syllabics, where you just count the number of syllables, but you do not alternate louder and softer syllables the way you do in regular English meter. So it was a way of counting something, but avoiding the sound of the poetry that I had been writing. And I think that there was a sense in me that I could write only in certain ways, only in certain tones and attitudes and cleverness and so on, that therefore I felt inarticulate. There were things in me that wanted to speak that couldn't speak. When I was writing that poem, I had no such thought, but I look back at it and remember what was going on in my head at that time. I think it was.